Alright, welcome back. In this tutorial, we will learn about the second learning objective of second chapter, the recording process. In second learning objective, we will learn about how a journal is used in recording process. So practically, businesses use three steps in recording process. In three steps, the one is analyze each business transaction. So the recording process begins with the transaction. Now, transactions involves the business documents, which are as a sale, a receipt, a check, or a balance. So these we will provide as a transaction evidence. So we will analyze and determine the business transactions effect on specific accounts. So once we have analyzed the transaction, then we will enter the transaction in a journal. So you will learn what is journal in coming slide, and then we will finally transfer the journal information to the ledger account. So these three steps are practically used in businesses. Once we have analyzed the business transaction, then we will enter in a journal. So journal is a book of original entry in which the transactions are recorded in a chronological order. Now chronological order is date wise we will record the transactions in journal book. So companies initially records transactions in a chronological order. Thus the journal is referred to as a book of original entry. For each transaction, the journal shows the debit and credit effects that we have learned in previous learning objective, the effects of debit and credit on a specific account. Companies may use various kinds of journals, but every company has the most basic form of journal is a general journal. So typically a general journal has the spaces for dates in which we will mention the dates, the account title, and the explanation of the transaction, and we will also give the reference of that transactions through the business documents that we have seen in first slides. The documents while sale slip or check or bill, etc., they are the references of the transactions. And two amount columns, you will see we will provide the two columns in general. So in coming slides we will practically demonstrate the journal. So I want to make your concepts theoretically clear. So there are two amount columns and we will see in coming illustration. Whenever we use the term journal, we mean that the general unless we specify otherwise. The journal makes several significant contributions to the recording process. So it contributes to the recording process. The first is discloses the complete effects of transaction. It shows the effects of each transaction and provides a chronological record of transaction. We will provide the date wise transaction. We will record the date wise transaction in general, and it helps to prevent or locate errors because the debit and credit amount can be easily compared. So we have learned that we will have to compare the debit and credit amount so that it reduces the errors in recording transactions and in the recording process. Now let's have a closer look on journal and demonstration. This is the demonstration illustration of general journal. So this is the illustration 2.13. So this is the format for general, and before proceeding to the illustration, when we are entering the transaction in a general, it is known as the journalizing. So it is important to learn about first journalizing. When we are entering the transaction data, इन अ जनरल इट इज नोन एज जनरलाइजिंग. सो कंपनीज मेक सेपरेट जनरल एंट्रीज फॉर ईच ट्रांजेक्शन एंड कंप्लीट एंट्री कंसिस्ट ऑफ थ्री थिंग्स. वन द डेट ऑफ ट्रांजेक्शन, सेकेंड द अकाउंट्स एंड द अमाउंट टू बी डेबिटेड और क्रेडिटेड. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल अ कंप्लीट एंट्री कंसिस्ट ऑफ थ्री थिंग्स. फर्स्ट द डेट ऑफ ट्रांजेक्शन. हेयर लाइक वी हैव गिवन द ट्रांजेक्शन डेट. द ट्रांजेक्शन इज ऑन सेप्टेम्बर. रे नील इन्वेस्टेड 15,000 इन कैश द बिजनेस एंड सॉफ्ट वाइट परचेज द कंप्यूटर इक्विपमेंट फॉर कैश एट $7,000 इन कैश. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल द एंट्री कंसिस्ट थ्री थिंग्स. द फर्स्ट इज द डेट ऑफ द ट्रांजेक्शन विच वी हैव प्रोवाइडेड इन जनरल जनरल. सो इट इज 1st September एंड देन वी विल प्रोवाइड द अकाउंट टाइटल. सो विच इज कैश. वी हैव इन्वेस्टेड इन बिजनेस 15,000. सो वेन कैश इंक्रीजेज इट इज रिकॉर्डेड इन डेबिट साइड. सो इट इज इम्पोर्टेंट फॉर यू गाइज टू लर्न फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल द रूल्स ऑफ डेबिट दैट आर डिस्कस्ड इन फर्स्ट लर्निंग ऑब्जेक्टिव. विदाउट नोइंग दीज रूल्स यू कैन नॉट प्रोसीड फर्दर एंड दे आर वेरी इसेंशियल फॉर दिस कोर्स. सो वेन कैश इंक्रीजेज इट इज रिकॉर्डेड ऑन द डेबिट साइड. So we have here seen that three things are involved in when we are entering the entry in general journal. So first the date of that transaction and the cash, the account title, and either it will be debited or credited. Let's proceed further. We have learned that the each transaction has dual effect. So we will record the cash on debit side and owner's capital. If owner's capital increases, it is recorded on credit side. We have learned, so we will also mention the 15,000 on credit side. So the first entry has made. Now this is the second entry in which in the day 1st September we have also purchased 7,000 equipment, which is the computer equipment. So we will here give the title as equipment, or you can also mention it the computer equipment. So it is cost of equipment is 7,000. So it if the assets increases, they will be recorded on debit side. That's why we have recorded the 7,000 on debit side. And the cash has decreases because we have purchased the equipment on cash. So we will, if the cash decreases, we will record on credit side. So cash will be decreases. So we will, if the cash decreases, it is recorded on credit side. This is the second illustration. First of all, I want to discuss with you two terms. First is sample and compound entries. So what is the difference between sample and compound entries? When we are generalizing entries, an entry involves two account that we have seen in previous transaction. The first of all, we have purchased the computer equipment and we will mention the equipment and cash. So the entry which involves only two accounts is known as simple entry, and the entry which involves more than two accounts, it is known as compound entries. So here you will find the entry which we are going to generalize in general journal, it is compound entry. So let's have a look how the compound entries are generalized. This is the illustration second. On 1st July, Butler Company purchases a delivery truck at the cost of $14,000 and it pays $8,000 cash and now agrees to pay the remaining balance on account. So the company has purchased 14,000 truck. It has paid 8,000 in cash and it agrees to pay the $6,000 in future. So this entry involves three accounts. One, the equipment that it has purchased, which is delivery truck, and the second, the cash which the company has paid. The third account will be generalized, which is the accounts payable. दिस एंट्री विल बी मेड इंटर्ड एज, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल मेंशन द इक्विपमेंट ऑफ डिलीवरी ट्रक एंड देन वी विल पे द कैश दैट वी हैव पेड, वी विल रिकॉर्ड इट एंड फाइनली वी विल एग्री टू पे द अकाउंट इन, वी विल रिकॉर्ड द 6,000 इन अकाउंट्स पेएबल दैट इट अमाउंट, दिस अमाउंट वी हैव टू पे इन फ्यूचर. सो दिस इज द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ कंपाउंड एंट्रीज इन विच द कंपाउंड एंट्री इन्वॉल्व थ्री अकाउंट्स. This was all about the second learning objective in which we have learned the three steps of recording process. So this is the action plan involved in second learning objective, the recording business activities. So we have learned the recording of business activities. Now we will have test our knowledge. Katie Browne, the first example which we have covered in first learning objective, engaged in the following activities in establishing hair saloon. The name is Hair It Is. So first of all, open a bank account. This is the first entry in which it has opened a bank account. The name of account is Hair It Is, and it deposited $20,000 for her own money in the account. So this is the owner's capital and as an initial investment which is made by the owner of the company. And the second transaction is purchased equipment on amount to be paid in 30 days. We have purchased equipment on credit for the total cost of equipment is 4,800. We have purchased the equipment on credit of 30 days. Interviewed three persons for the position of hair stylist, and we have interviewed the three persons for hair stylist. Now we have to prepare the entries to record these three transactions. So first entry, opened the cash account, we will record as, we will provide the date. First we will provide the date and then we will record in the account title as cash, and if the cash increases, it will be recorded on debit side. We will record $20,000 on debit side. If the owner's capital increases, it will be recorded on credit side as $20,000. It is recorded on credit side. And in second transaction, first mention the date of that transaction. Then we will provide the equipment title, and then we will record in debit side because the asset increases recorded by debit side. So 4,800 we will record on debit side. And in second account, we have purchased the equipment on credit, that's why we will record on accounts payable 4,800 because the equipment is purchased on debit. And the third account, the third in transaction in which interviewed three persons for the position of hair stylist. The third entry will not entered in the general journal because we cannot quantify this transaction in terms of money. That's why such types of transactions will not be included in accounting process. We have learned in first chapters in which we have learned about the transactions, which transactions will be recorded or not. You are advised to do all related exercises of this learning objective. And this was all about the second learning objective. If you have any kind of question or suggestion, kindly drop in comment box. And for getting latest uploads, kindly do subscribe and click on the bell icon. We'll meet in third learning objective. Thank you.